Why, there's Pocoyo. Look, he's...
What is he doing?
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Can any of you see or hear what Pocoyo is doing?
Drumming. He's playing the drum.
Exactly. He's drumming. It makes a fine noise, doesn't it? Yes, the drum is a wonderful instrument. Oh, my. Yes, that is quite a big sound, Pocoyo. Yes, indeed, Pocoyo. Pocoyo! Pocoyo! Yes, well, the drums are quite...
Drum! Loud!
Yes, loud. Perhaps you could... Pocoyo?
Show friends!
Pocoyo! Pocoyo! Oh, I believe Sleepy Bird was taking a nap. I'm not sure she wants to do any drumming right now. Or hear any, I'm afraid. Oh, here's Elly, and how lovely she's dancing. My, are you all right, Elly? Pocoyo, I don't think Elly wants to drum right now either. She's dancing.
Pato! Drum! Drum!
Pocoyo, I'm afraid Pato doesn't want to drum either. Oh, Pocoyo, wait. I'm afraid Pocoyo's a bit upset. Pocoyo? Pocoyo? I know you wanted to drum, but sometimes not everyone wants to do exactly the same thing you do at exactly the same time you want to do it. But maybe if you wait a bit and check back with them later when they're finished with
drum.
Yes, I know, Pocoyo. Why don't you drum a little now? There's not really anyone around to upset. I mean, to appreciate it at the moment. Oh, look, Pocoyo! It's... Pocoyo, if I might stop you for a moment? I think your friends want to do some drumming now, Pocoyo.
Elly, Pato, drum!
Yes, well, as they say, good things, or in this case, loud things, come to those who learn to wait. Hooray for Pocoyo! See you soon! Pocoyo and Elly. They're out for a ride. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Elly. There's nothing like a relaxing ride on a nice day to make you feel wonderful and bring friends together. Oh my! It seems like Elly and Pocoyo's relaxing little ride together is becoming a race. And there's Pato. But where's he going? Aha! There he is, I see. Pato wants Elly and Pocoyo to have a real race. How exciting! Gather round, everyone. Elly and Pocoyo are going to have a race to see who's faster. I think Pato wants to get things going. So what are you going to say to get the race started, Pato? Yes, you say ready, steady, and then what comes next, Pato? Oh dear, Pato can't remember what comes next. Can any of you help Pato to get the race started? Say it with me. Ready, steady, go! And they're off! Well done, isn't it thrilling? Pocoyo and Elly are neck and neck. Oh, and I think they've woken Sleepy Bird. Oh, and look, it seems as though she wants to join the race as well. Oh, it doesn't look like she can go very fast. It looks as though Elly is taking the lead. Oh no, what bad luck! Elly appears to be stuck in the sand. And there goes Pocoyo, leaving poor Elly in the dust. I mean sand. Wait a moment. Looks like Elly has an idea. What's she going to do? She's pulling herself out. Pull, Elly, pull! Nice going, Pocoyo. You're way ahead. You're working up quite a sweat, aren't you? Oh, my. This is very strange. What are you doing now, Pocoyo?
Ice cream.
You're eating an ice cream in the middle of the race? Well, I must say, you must be feeling pretty confident if you're eating ice cream. Oh, Elly. Well, you'd better get going if you want to win the race, Pocoyo. And he's off again. Look at that Pocoyo go. Oh, and there's Sleepy Bird. Pocoyo and Elly are neck and neck again. What a race. Oh, no. What was that? It looks like the car and scooter have fallen apart and so close to the finish. Oh dear, how are Pocoyo and Elly going to finish the race without a car or scooter? You know, I wonder if there's a way you might still be able to finish the race. Just think, Pocoyo. You have a bit that still works, and Elly, you have another bit. Is there a way you can make a new vehicle, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo and Elly work out how they could make something new? Yes, if you put each of your pieces together, you can finish the race together in style. Look at that! Pocoyo and Elly have made a caruta. Perfect! It appears that you both won the race together. Oh, well, actually, it seems that Sleepy Bird is the winner. Ah, I suppose it just goes to show. It's really not who gets to the finish line first that matters. The fun is all in how you get there. And with whom. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
And just where are you off to in such a hurry? My, what a wonderful castle Elly has built. Don't you think so, Pocoyo? What is it, Elly? Is something the matter? Oh, I see. There's something missing. Pocoyo, can you see what's missing from Ellie's castle? Can any of you help Pocoyo work out what's missing from the castle?
The flag is missing.
That's right. It needs a flag. Oh my goodness! What does Elly mean? I think Ellie's telling you not to touch the castle while she's away. And she wants you to make sure no one else touches it either.
Don't touch.
Yes, well done, Pocoyo.
Don't touch.
Oh, it's Loula.
Don't touch.
What are you thinking? Oh, it's Pato!
Pato, don't touch!
I don't think Pato was very interested.
Don't touch! Don't touch!
I don't know if that's such a good idea, Pocoyo. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what Elly said? It looks like Pocoyo wants to show us something. Let's have a look. What is it, Pocoyo? I can't see anything. Pocoyo, what are you up to? Yes, well done, Pocoyo. Well, I think perhaps there's someone here who needs to say something. Ah, there you are, Pocoyo.
Elly, Pocoyo touch. Sorry, Elly.
Good for you, Pocoyo. You've said sorry, and now you're doing something to try to make Elly feel better. You did it! You rebuilt the castle, and it's better than ever! Hooray for Pocoyo and Elly! Nothing is ever unfixable when you're friends. Bye-bye! See you soon!
Pato!
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
But what's that you're doing? Following somebody's trails? I wonder who left those footprints. They're rather small. I think I know. They are exactly the same size as Pocoyo's feet. Can anyone help Pocoyo guess who made those footprints?
Pocoyo!
It's Pocoyo's feet.
They're quite right. Pocoyo, you're following your own footprints. But what's that? Look, there are more footprints. And whoever left them isn't wearing shoes at all. In fact, I think they've got little paws instead of feet. Who left those prints? Do you know, Pocoyo? Well, did you leave those prints, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo guess whose prints those are?
A dog!
It's Loula!
Why, you're right! It was Loula! You see, sometimes we leave tracks or prints behind us, like when we walk on sand at the beach. Now, those are very mysterious. Who or what do you suppose left those?
Round.
Yes, they are round.
Big!
You're right. It's big, too. Much bigger than your footprint, Pocoyo. Big, round feet. I wonder who on earth it could be. Pocoyo, do you know who could be leaving these tracks? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who has been making these big, round tracks?
Elly!
You're right! It's Pocoyo's good friend, Elly. Hello, Elly! You certainly do have big feet, Elly. Now here's someone who's leaving some very interesting footprints. Hello, Pato. Going for a swim? What prints are these?
Big!
Yes, whoever left these prints has great big feet, even bigger than Ellie's. And whoever it is has webbed feet. Whoever left those footprints, it certainly wasn't a boy, a dog, or an elephant, was it, Pocoyo? So who could it be?
What's that?
Oh no, Pocoyo. I don't think it could be a monster. Pocoyo? Pocoyo? If you just take a look... Pocoyo, I know it looks as though the monster is very close by, but really, there's no need to panic.
Wow.
Look, Pato, that's strange, isn't it? The prints are right behind you. Can you see who left those scary-looking footprints, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo whose feet match these footprints?
Pato!
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 It was Pato all along, in his flippers, going for a swim. Hooray for Pocoyo! You solved the mystery of the great big monster. Good work. Bye-bye. See you soon.